Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be showing you the entry and exit requirements for Kenya. So we get started here with a Google search. I'm going to scroll down to the US Embassy in Kenya information because I'm from the US. If you're from another country, you may want to check with your embassy to see if there are any additional requirements for your country specifically. So at the beginning, they just have some general information about curfew, country information. What we're going to focus on here is the entry and exit requirement section, okay, as you can see here. So first, I would definitely book your ticket first and your hotel, because when you apply for your visa, they're going to ask you to provide that information. So here you see that you have to apply for your e-visa. You can no longer get your visa at the airport. So here is the visa you have to apply for in advance, the e-visa. You have a few options here. You have single entry, transit, courtesy entry, East African tourist, multiple entry, or 5-year multiple entry. So if you do the multiple entry, just to show you some of the requirements here, you have to have your return ticket, valid travel document less than 6 months, and it's valid for 3 to 12 months. So if you want to travel back and forth to Kenya for longer than 12 months, you might want to go for the 5-year visa. It's $101, and as you can see here, there are some additional requirements, your hotel bookings if you're a tourist, and your photo requirements. You do have to submit a photo, and it says here, if you normally wear glasses, which I do, you must take your photo with them. Some people require that you take them off, but this one says it should be worn in your picture. All right, so check all of the requirements here before you take your picture so that you don't run into any issues later down the line. So that's a multiple entry. Now they do have the 5-year multiple entry, and then they also have the East African tourist. This one, let's see, it's valid for 3 months. So this is not a long period of time. Again, $101 for that one. Then we have the 5-year, which provides you a much longer time period, and this is $201. And again, you want to check over all of the requirements here before you submit your application. For my trip that I just took to Kenya, I did the single entry visa, and this one was pretty quick, but to be honest with you, I should have done the multiple entry because I'll be going back to Kenya in the near future. So these fees here for the single entry is $51, and then of course you need to look at all of the requirements in order to submit that. So you're going to book your ticket first, you're going to book your hotel, then the third step is to apply for your e-visa on this website, okay? Now you can create a login for this website so that you can check back after 2 to 3 weeks to see if it's been approved. I never received an email from them, so I had to go back to log in, and my e-visa was there for download. Next, it says incoming travelers must have this QR code. This is the International Travelers Health Surveillance Form. You have to fill this out in order to be issued a QR code. They will check this code at the airport upon arrival, so you must fill out this form to get that QR code. If you don't have it, you will have to go through that process at the airport, and I'm not sure if they will allow you entry and how long it will take you to get the QR code, all right? So this is the next step. After you do your e-visa, you come here, fill out this form, get your QR code, and keep that in place. Now, this does require that, it does ask you if you have a negative PCR test. So as soon as you get that negative PCR test, fill this out immediately so that you can get that QR code issued to you. They will send it to you via email. You want to print that out and have it with you on hand. The next step here is that this Trusted Traveler initiative is for when you depart. The QR code is for arrival, all right? So I'm going to go over the exit requirements in just a little bit. But the Trusted Traveler code is important, and you will get that when you get your test from Kenya, your PCR test. There will be a Trusted Traveler code on there if you go to the approved laboratories. All right. This is a Trusted Travel website. This is where you can fill out your information about where you're going, where is your departure airport, and it will tell you the travel requirements. Now, I did not create a login for this beforehand. When you get tested in Kenya to return back to wherever you're going, I was coming back to Rwanda, they will give you the login information for this website on the test results. So you can create that or just use the login that they give you, and you can log in, see your test results. And then you also have to validate your test results while you're inside of the system. And they give you a second code that you need for travel. So there's a lot of little steps that you need to just pay attention to here. And it's not very complicated, you just have to be organized. Now, I always recommend that you print out all copies of these documents, because they will be checked at the airport multiple times, and you need to make sure that you have everything on hand in a folder. Now, I just want to point out here, if you see here, it says US citizens must be tested within 3 calendar days of departure. So that's 72 hours before you depart the country that you're leaving from. However, when you scroll down to the exit entry requirements, it says 96 hours. So there's a little bit of conflict there, but to be on the safer side, I always go with the shorter time frame. So I got tested within the 72 hour time frame before departure, so that I was within all of the guidelines that was required there. Next, you will need to book your COVID-19 PCR test. I needed it within 72 hours prior to departing Kenya. So I went online to book an appointment in Kenya. I chose Lancet. This is in Upper Hill on Gong Avenue. I highly recommend them. You can book your appointment online, which is what I did way before I even got to Kenya. I chose the date that I needed, which would fall within that 72 hour window before coming back to Rwanda, and everything was very smooth. So as you can see here, the top calendar is for areas inside of Nairobi, and the bottom calendar is for areas outside of Nairobi. So you want to figure out where you're going to be. For me, I was going to be within Nairobi, so I chose the top calendar, and you choose your correct date. Now, when you select a particular date, when you click on it, then a few windows will come up with time slots. So you can choose the time slot that fits your schedule. And let me just show you an example here. So let's just say I wanted September 3rd and I clicked on the calendar. As you can see here, there are a few time slots. So you would choose which one you like, book the appointment, and then you would fill out the forms, and you would have your appointment set for that date and time. So I highly recommend Lancet if you're inside of Nairobi. I thought this was very efficient. I had no problems. Now, when you get your lab results, which is normally 24 to 48 hours later, there will be the trusted traveler code listed on your actual PCR test results, okay? So that will be already listed for you. They also provided the login information for the Trusted Traveler website. So I was able to log in. If I wanted to download it onto my computer, I could do that. And then, as you can see here, the Trusted Traveler is for exiting Kenya. You need to get that traveler code when you're exiting. Now, also within the portal, you should validate your COVID-19 PCR test. There is a button inside there where you can validate. It generates a secondary QR code, okay? I only found that out because I flew Kenya Airways and they required that. So guys, it's important, whatever airline you're flying with, that you check to see if they have any additional requirements specifically for them. So Kenya Airways required that I validate the PCR negative results, and that would generate a secondary QR code that was needed to exit Kenya. So I went ahead and I did that inside of the portal, the Trusted Travel portal. Easy to find, easy to do. Remember, these travel requirements change frequently because of COVID, so it's important that you check the information before you travel just to get the updated info. All right, guys, remember to share, like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Take care. Bye.